Mace production. I can't hear y'all clapping. Tomorrow go home.
Apply my life to be somebody. Yeah. my life was hard. I had a family. We was real ambitious as a family. But as you see your parents coming up and they showing you their way of trying to be something, it ain't always right. But they trying to find their way. I watched my family do a lot of things. And as I become a young man, and I had time to reflect back on some stuff, they were doing a lot of things wrong. So,
sun will wash me from my sins, clean this house from the inside out, restore me, take away my smoking a lot and drinking a lot and all up in the club. I've been doing this, I've been doing that, and I had no business doing it. No church or no Bible study ain't been in my word. Now I know better than this, can't live my life in sin. We confess to Him, He'll remove all wickedness. The blood from your Son will
able to hang. It's young people day, y'all. It's young people day. You got to be able to hang. Now, if you can't hang, and if you don't have a reason to lift your hands, let me give you one. Okay, I gotta come down here and give you one. He woke you up this morning with brand new mercy. Even though I did this perfect. God has been good to me. Hey! I just gave you one. it would have, hold on 1 second. Stay right there. Stay where you at. Because we got to realize it's not about you. It's not about what you got on. It's not about how big you are. It's not about how good you can talk. It's not about how much I wrote down to say to you. It ain't even about that. Hey, hallelujah. Now, God said instructions. I am God, the healer, the ruler. Ah, oh, yeah, 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 yeah. The, ah, oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. I need to say. Some of you been down lately. The devil been hanging on your back so tough. You come to church and you sit there and you say, Lord, is it 2 o'clock yet? Is it 3 o'clock yet? But I'm gonna tell you what. Tomorrow is Monday morning. It's another week. Today is Sunday. You don't have to take that mess back home with you. You don't have to take that mess back home with you. Hey! God said, your circumstance ain't gonna consume you. Your circumstance ain't gonna bring you down. Draw up the God in you. You know how to do it. You know how to do it. Hey, God. God said, you that one. You different. You different. Come out. God said, hallelujah. I'm almost finished. God said, I'm going to show myself. Sister Kim.
The first lady who serves the pastor who serves God. The change begin and end with one who serves God's house. Well, that being said, I say to you, Pastor Henry Bradley, well done, good, and faithful servant.
Thank you.
I wished to love you, and I died for you, so why can't you love me? He said, so still he said, let us love one another. And then I'm going to go over here to, when Jesus talks about love, he is reaching out to us. He wants us for himself. So when we be disobedient, we are headed for danger. When we begin to move toward the place of alienation from God, love, then his spirit gets jealous and hovers over our spirit and makes us come back to the Lord. God is jealous when we don't rest in his love.
Luke 9 and 26 says, for whosoever shall be ashamed of me and of my words, of him shall the Son of Man be ashamed when he shall come in his own glory and in his Father's and of the holy angels. If we are ashamed of Jesus on earth, how will we ever be comfortable in heaven to spread an eternity with him? Don't be ashamed to talk and tell others that you belong to him, because you may be helping that person and not even realizing what they are going through. Right. Each one of us go through different things. Amen. I done been through something, so I can talk and tell and testify on what I've been through. We all can talk and tell and testify and just spread the word and spread the goodness to everybody.
Amen. We all be long. But if I could sing Mine's Its Own Encouragement, I would have sung Encourage Yourself. But I can't do it. I don't want y'all to laugh. But it's a beautiful song, and I sure wish I could sing it because it would have took me 10 minutes. But mine's its own encouraging, and Webster Dictionary said to give courage, hope, or confidence, to give support, and to help. So I thank God because I have to encourage myself, because I'm not the one to get up and like to talk, But somebody insists, since I'm married to the pastor, I have to get up. So I hope the Lord really bless me to learn how to talk in front of people, because I am not the one, but I want the Lord to give me some encouraged words too. But I had read in Psalms 27 and 14, wait on the Lord, be of good courage, and he shall strengthen thy heart. Wait, I said, on the Lord. So I would like to encourage each and everyone, no matter what you're going through, whatever situation, whatever your problem, be encouraged. It might seem like the Lord don't answer our prayers. We might be looking for a husband. Christine always tells me the Lord don't hear her prayer. But I just said, don't give up. Because, not you. Christine, the other Christine, not you. But it seemed like the Lord don't hear our prayer, but he do. And it's just something about this scripture when it said, wait on the Lord. And if you be patient, I really believe the Lord will give you what you desire. And sometimes we don't understand. And then we be saying, Lord, I want you to do it right now. But don't give up, because the scripture said, wait on the Lord. And then I thank God for what we got.
That's right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
That's good. Sister Carol Morrison got up here and she told us about the chain and how every department in our church helps. And every time that department helps, it gets that chain stronger and stronger. So when that chain becomes stronger and stronger, that becomes easier for the pastor to serve and do what he needs to do, because every department is doing what they need to do. Yes, yeah, so once a department stops, and then that's a loose link in that chain, but once everybody is going what they need to do in that chain to making it stronger, whew, that makes it easier for him. Sister Christine, she covered love. So while we're building up that chain and we kept on building up love in that chain, oh my God, that chain going to be awesome.
Amen.
You know, you build up the love in the choir, that's the chain. You build up the love in the deacon board, that's the chain.
Yeah.
You keep on building up that love while you keep on building up that chain. We're going to have an awesome chain. Whew. Thank the Lord for that. And then Sister Phyllis came out. Okay, we got the people who's in here right now. You know, we're here. Then we need new blood. We get to get out there and witness to different people, to bring them in, to help us with that chain, to help us with that love. You know, so that makes our church grow a little stronger and show that we have love to get out there and witness to people, to help us to get a little higher and help the pastor do what he needs to do for us.
Amen.
Okay, then we had the first lady come up with encouragement. With all this building, all this chain, and all this love, we need encouragement every now and then. You know, because sometimes things can get hard for you. Sometimes building that chain can get hard. But if you have somebody in there encouraging you to do what you need to do and say, well, job, good job. I like the way you did that. I like the way you stood up for her.
Right.
You know, that chain becomes stronger. That love becomes stronger. Our witness becomes stronger, which causes our pastor to become stronger.
Absolutely.
Which causes us to become stronger. Whew. We got an awesome chain up in here. That's what I'm talking about. Whew. So I appreciate our pastor giving us this time to teach us how to grow this chain, for we can get stronger among each other and spread this love. Thank you. Now I'm giving it over to the pastor.
Jesus. told. One of the lies our history starts when we were sold. One of the lies taught us every day. When we went to school, black history had no place. What are the lies? How long must this last? I'll tell you the truth.
If you would like to know more about your heritage, please stop by the Cosby Educational Heritage Center in the OC Hill Neighborhood Center at 445 Bowman Street. For appointments, please call us at 419-775-8834 or 419-571-4627. And always remember, education is the key.